I'm Sally Hernandez, your Travis County Sheriff, and I would like to take this opportunity to explain how the Travis County Sheriff's Office will work to keep our community safe and coordinate with federal immigration authorities while respecting the constitutional and civil rights of the residents of Travis County. I want to make it clear the Travis County Sheriff's Office will continue to work with all fellow law enforcement agencies, local, state, and federal. We will also continue to honor all lawfully issued warrants and hold those inmates for our fellow officers in law enforcement. I'm committed to public safety. Under the previous detainer policy, an inmate who was charged with a crime was deported as soon as he posted bond or before his court date. As such, the inmate never went before a court, the victim and their family never had their day in court, and the inmate's criminal record would grow. This system does not foster public safety. Public safety is fostered whenever there is accountability and closure. Being committed to public safety also means that I will do all that I can to ensure victims report crime and witnesses cooperate with Travis County deputies. The Travis County Sheriff's Office must enact policies that build public trust, including policies that make it clear that as local law enforcement officers, we will not interrogate or arrest someone over an unrelated federal immigration matter if they are trying to report a crime. The public must be confident that local law enforcement is focused on local public safety, not on federal immigration enforcement. Our jail cannot be perceived as a holding tank for ICE or that Travis County deputies are ICE officers. It's absolutely imperative for officers to have the trust of the public during their interaction. All members of our community must feel comfortable joining us as partners in our efforts to arrest violent abusers, drug dealers, and those who traffic women and children, and all those who rob, steal, and hurt others. We cannot afford to make our community less safe by driving people into the shadows. It is my policy to focus on local public safety priorities and leave it to federal immigration officials to focus on federal immigration enforcement. Travis County Sheriff's Office deputies and resources will be focused on serious criminals and true threats to public safety, regardless of immigration status. We will work with federal immigration officials, but this office will not increase our liability or set unwise public safety priorities simply to ease the burden of the federal government. Immigration officials already have access to information anytime a person is booked in our jail. If immigration officials determine a person is illegally present in the United States and they get a warrant from a judge to lawfully detain that person, we will honor it. ICE knows the alleged immigration law violator is in our jail, and case information is already available. Nothing we are doing will interfere with their mission. I want to clarify the sheriff's role in the criminal justice system. I'm not a judge who sets bond or oversees the court process. I do not have the legal or constitutional authority to hold someone once a judge has ordered that person be released. It's important to note that the voluntary detainer requests from ICE are just that, voluntary. These requests are not orders from a judge, and they do not provide me with additional authority to hold someone. Although the exact limitation of these detainer requests are being argued in court, it is clear that holding people beyond their sentence in the jail once they have already been ordered released by a local judge creates potential liability for Travis County, the community, and me. This is why everyone arrested in Travis County will be treated the same under the law, as our Constitution requires. If federal immigration officials believe they have enough evidence to prove that a person is illegally in the country or that they should be held in my jail beyond their release date, they can go to a federal judge to issue a warrant to detain that person, as is generally required by the law under both statutes and court decisions to make an arrest. A recent federal court ruling held that seeking to detain individuals without a warrant and without a determination by ICE that the individuals are likely to escape exceeds the authority Congress granted to the Department of Homeland Security. I want to explain that our policy on ICE detainer requests recognizes these requests offer incomplete information. An immigration detainer does not automatically mean that a person with a detainer is here illegally or that he will be deported. ICE itself releases tens of thousands of people every year from their custody after picking them up from local jails. That's more than Travis County ever could. Some are released due to mistakes, and others due to ICE deciding it is unnecessary to further detain them. There is also an entire immigration deportation court system that releases several of these same inmates on immigration bonds. And later in their immigration court proceedings, many of these individuals have their cases closed, allowing them to stay in the United States. Others are granted status as permanent residencies, and several more receive work permits, which allow them to get Social Security cards while they are free on bond and waiting on final disposition of their cases. So the notion that all Travis County inmates with immigration detainers in the past were deported is not only false, but in many cases, these same people were released and allowed to stay here. I want to reiterate my commitment to being a good steward of our public safety resources. Immigration detainers issued by the federal government cost Travis County taxpayer dollars and tie up jail beds. This doesn't make any sense because the Sheriff's Office was never intended to, nor is it capable of acting as an immigration detention office. We are not able nor authorized to make a determination on whether somebody is legally presented in the United States, has a legal status, or is in the process of getting status. Federal immigration enforcement is left solely to the federal officials, partly because this federal law is complicated and its enforcement can be very difficult. Unfortunately, even federal officials don't always get it right. There are hundreds and perhaps thousands of examples nationwide of immigration detainers being placed unlawfully, resulting in the illegal detention of immigrants who were lawfully present on visas, lawfully permanent residents, and sometimes, amazingly, even U.S. citizens. Those local county jails who trusted and acted on immigration officials' behalf ended up violating the constitutional rights of those individuals and subjected their local county to lawsuits, in some instances resulting in local government having to pay hundreds of thousands of dollars in legal fees and settlements. Detention costs you directly as a taxpayer. The overwhelming cost of detaining hundreds of individuals in the jail who would otherwise be out on bond or who are held beyond their release date is paid by county taxpayers. These costs are not being reimbursed by the federal government. The continued detention results in job loss, families forced onto public assistance, and sometimes the requirement of the county to pay for a court-appointed attorney for many. They are also unable to seek treatment, receive parenting classes, work in order to pay for restitution to victims, and fulfill their important roles as parents, spouses, and members of the workforce. This has a destructive effect on Travis County that ultimately affects school children, our families, county budgets, and resources. It is our privilege and pleasure to commit our best effort to secure public safety, follow the law, and keep costs down by focusing on our mission. We'll work with other law enforcement agencies to keep Travis County safe while honoring the will of the people. Thank you.